4 regular meals and 3 small ones each day. Now. What the hell's going on over there?
Sorry.
I will need 2 judges on the floor at all times. Nurses and trainers in the rest areas. Any questions, come up and ask them. Hey, fellas, give me a break. In a couple hours, we fling open the magic doors of fame and fortune, so line up and get your number. What do you want, these Rocky? Turkey. Check the rest areas.
Some sisters, just like the fleet, line up and wait a little longer.
Hey. How about boosting it up a little?
You get your turn. Take it easy, huh? Hey, what's this love? No, that's for my stomach. I got a bad stomach. Paragoric opium paste. No number.
Hey, look, he's got another one.
It's medicine. I gotta take it for my stomach.
So take it somewhere else. I got no trouble about a hop in.
You learn them schools all the flow.
That's no pitch, because the guy's got a better lawyer.
Come on, Nick. Move it up.
Once between hitches, I worked a cattle boat out of Galveston. Same thing, you know what I mean?
No, I didn't think I'd do that.
Well, what I mean is, if you think about it, cattle ain't got it much worse than us.
They got it better. There's always somebody feeding them.
Sure. Stuffing them up good for the slaughter pen. Right down the chute, and some big dumb bullhunk is standing there with a sledgehammer. Boom.
But they don't know what's gonna happen. That puts one up on us, don't it?
Yeah. If you think of it that way. What's the matter with him?
Nothing.
Is he a special of some kind?
I'm an actress. Alice LeBlanc. From London.
What do you got, like an actor, but maybe let's see a little... Well, if you give us a few seconds, we could work something up, okay?
Yes. They told me you were fools, but I was not listening to your fine words, nor trust to your charity.
Jesus Christ.
You promised me my life, but you lied. I think that life is nothing but not being stone dead.
Hey, that's great. I really mean it. Shakespeare, huh?
It's from some joke.
Yeah, I'll just wait for you. Maybe it's a little too highbrow, but don't you worry. I'll put up something just right for you. Okay, hey. Hey, sailor. Sailor.
My mother?
It's your feet, sailor.
Next. Move it. Move it.
Doc. You sick or something?
It's all right.
Open elbow. Wider. Huh? Wider.
What is this? He's all right.
Bronchitis, maybe. Maybe the Mongolian front. No dice, kid. You infect the whole place like you're the health department setting your bus park. That's the way it is.
Hey. I'm sorry, Gloria.
That's a big help. Listen, you're the one that talked me into this.
I'm sorry.
Hey. Hey, what about me?
I'm sorry. How many you got?
That's what he said. I can't quite fucking see this.
Look, I can't make exceptions. How many you got?
Shove you one bunch on a whole amount of two pros.
What about her? Hey, she ain't pregnant. I'm Nelson Eddy.
So what's healthier than having a kid? And it gives the audience something to root for.
You see, so what do you want me to do? Run out quick, get knocked up?
We could discuss it later.
That soap's a little hard.
Sure, is this or not?
Just hold on a second. You got any other suggestions?
Get yourself another partner.
Yeah, where?
Hey, cowboy! Yeah, you! Come here!
Good luck, Tracy. Keep the line moving.
Look, I was just out walking. I didn't come here to be an artifact.
What's your name, cowboy?
Robert Cyber.
In a minute!
You got a partner, Richard?
No, it's Robert.
No, I was walking.
There you are, Liz.
How's he gonna dance in those things?
You know. Boots?
They're not mine.
I roomed with another guy. He went away and left them behind.
He's gonna break an arch.
Take him off a pair of shoes. Or maybe you'd rather wait for the Prince of Wales.
Have I got a choice?
Yeah. Take it or leave it.
Yowza, yowza, yowza. Welcome to the Dance of Destiny, ladies and gentlemen. Around and around and around we go, and we're only beginning, folks. Only beginning. On and on and on. And when will it stop? When will it end? When? Only when the last two of these wonderful, starry-eyed kids are left. Only when the last two dancers stagger and sway, stumble and swoon across the sea of defeat and despair to victory. One couple and only one will waltz out of here over broken bodies and broken dreams, carrying the grand prize of $1,500 silver dollars. Mr. Lightman! The clock of fate, ladies and gentlemen. I said the prize. Because only one couple will dance on to fame and fortune. Those who give up, those who give out, those who give in. Out! Tough rules, but these are tough times. In the words of our great leader, Herbert Hoover, prosperity is just around the corner. But what do we say about the Depression? That's what we say about the Depression. Come on, let's hear it, folks. Let's hear it.
Walking Dead Night Turkey, pour me a shot of water.
So pick your couple, folks. Struggle with them, hope with them, cry with them. See if you can pick out that one lucky couple and then cheer them on. Come on, let them hear you care, folks. Let them know you're with them all the way. Hear that, kids? You hear those wonderful folks out there rooting for you? Now come on, kids, show them you care. A little sprint for those wonderful folks out there. That's it. You see them give, folks? You see them give? That's the spirit.
Why California?
No, freeze while you're starting. Because the movies.
Oh, are you an actress?
I've done four atmosphere bits since I've been here. I'd have done more, but I can't get into central casting. They got it all sewed up.
Don't you know anyone who can help you?
In this business, how can you tell who can help you? One day you're an electrician, the next day you're a producer. The only way I could ever get near a big shot is to jump on the running board of this car.
Check that one.
Anyway, I don't know if the men stars can help me as much as the women stars. From what I've been seeing lately, I think I've been letting the wrong sex brother make me. You in movies too?
Sort of. I was a dead French villager in Fallen Angels.
Time, kiddo. You think casting from Sternberg's Raw Earth should be an old peasant funky?
I could play a peasant.
Not on that thing, you could.
Do you like
that? Doesn't matter.
That's a long as they do.
Hey, sweetie. Got another partner, huh? Oh, only he don't look much healthier than the last one.
What are you, a
doctor?
He don't need nothing, honey.
I'm just trying to be helpful. Cod liver oil. You want to take some, maybe?
He's just steaming because you got 20 years old. Maybe more like 30.
Well, that's where you got your signals mixed up, sweetie. Yeah, experience, that's what counts. Keep your eyes open, Buster. Pick up the beat and try to stay with you, will you? Stop time!
Pieces of shrapnel still embedded in Harry's body. 32! And here he is fighting another kind of war and fighting to win. Isn't that the kind of grit and never say die spirit that's made this a great country it is, isn't it? You bet it is. And I really mean that sincerely, folks, from the bottom of my heart.
I should learn how to tap dance.
Hey, you ain't never lugging me. Just keep thinking about them 7 meals a day they're gonna be feeding us. Can you feel that?
What?
The ocean. The waves. You can feel them right through the floor. You know, even when you're a long ways away from it, you still feel it sometimes.
Not where I'm from.
Where's that?
Around. Kansas, Texas, mostly Dallas.
That must have been nice.
Nice.
Well, I've never actually been through there, but that's the way it always seemed to me. You know, like you could look just about anywhere and see land. I mean, with nothing set down on it.
Yeah, it's great. I'm a real sucker for dirt and cactus. That's up on my left.
Well, why did you?
You ever been to bed with a Syrian who chewed tobacco? Well, if anybody ever asks you, you can tell them there's no future in it. What do you want, the whole floor?
Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
I wish he's throwing it around. Her feet will last longer than her rear end. He was a butcher.
Who was he?
Syria.
Hey, listen, I didn't mean to be personal. I didn't mean to be personal.
Yeah, then why'd you ask?
Just to make conversation. I mean, we're going to be stuck together for a long time.
Don't strain it.
Yowza, yowza, yowza. This is novelty night. We've got a husband and wife dancing together. Mr. and Mrs. Aura McCusick Mary from Minneapolis, Minnesota. There's a couple from Alaska. Remember, there's no place like Nome. Don't forget to write your poor old mother. Yowza, yowza, yowza.
All right, kids, it's opening night. Smile for the audience.
What audience?
Don't worry about that. Get you disqualified.
I've been disqualified by exorcists.
Ten minutes and then they'll be back. And the World Championship Marathon will go on and on and on and on and on.
Yes.
Excuse me, girls. Mr. Blank, got that specialty bit down yet?
I'm memorizing it now. Every line.
Swell, come by my office next break, maybe we'll run through it.
Let me get off your feet.
The baby do?
I don't know.
What the doctor says?
Well, see, James and me been hitching, riding boxcars.
Nature's little miracle. Christ.
What?
What's the use of having a kid unless you've got enough dough to take care of it?
You better get off your feet, honey. You only got another 5 minutes.
Folks can't stop having babies because they don't got no money.
You intend to keep it?
Well, I could never get... Kimmy wants a baby.
Yeah. Why not drop another sucker into this mess?
I told you guys, no roughhousing. Now, no grab ass there, college kid.
I'll get out of there, boy.
Well, this ain't for me. I got sensitive feet. Next time, I think I'm gonna try flagpole sitting. You guys are crazy.
Now, that's really pitiful, man. Can't even make it to the first rest period. This here's my 8th marathon already. My wife and I didn't want one in Oklahoma City one time. 1,253 hours of continuous motion.
First one of these, I get me. I'm fine. Late first cabin. Hell, it ain't even steerage, but it's better than nothing.
Well, I figured I wasn't doing anything else real important, so here I am.
You know what I'd do if I was your age, kid? I'd join up all over again in the fleet.
No, I don't think I'd like that. I mean, I'd like to be able to move on if I got bored or something, you know?
Bumming? That's all right for a while. Man's got to belong somewhere. You know, be part of something. I mean, that's human nature, right?
I guess I never really thought about it much.
Yeah, well, you will. When you get to be my age, you will. Not that I'm at all, you know. That's the muscles up there that count, kid. Even more so than your legs. Right up in there.
She wait for you. The petals of many flowers will fall, but they are going away. Forever.
That is terrible.
Well, it just doesn't suit me. I'll ask Mr. Grover to find something else for us.
I think you'd better. Hey, I'd
slips. Get that in Paris?
No. My mother made it for me. She liked it.
It's, very nice.
Easy go. Here we are. So darling.
After the first 100 hours, you struck an east of this. What are you looking at?
There's a partially broken window up there, seems like. I was trying to see if it was light out here.
It's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, I know. Sometimes down by the beach, it gets light by four. It's like that in Hawaii. Because it's an island, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. Well, like, you can look right out across the ocean to where the light is. You can even stand in one spot and watch the sun come up on one side of the world and go down on the other side.
How'd you get out there, Hawaii?
Oh, I've never been there, actually. You can imagine what it's like.
Yeah, you can imagine you're Gary Cooper, too, I suppose.
Oh, I didn't mean that at all. Look, why are you always trying to start an argument? All I meant was you tell that twist to lay off of my wife. She was at it again. Every one of them rest periods, she's on her all the time about why don't she have it cut out? Why don't she get rid of it? Well, she's giving Ruby the jumps, and I ain't having my wife upset by no tramp like her.
Go to hell, you big ape.
Boy, next time I'm gonna
go. Knock it off! Well, you know the rules, no fights on the floor. What do you think, this is a joint or something?
I'm keeping an eye on you.
Which one? Stupid, you see the face on that corn pony, could have killed you.
Yeah, I did.
Well, then why did you do it?
Because you're my partner.
You know, I got the curse coming on. Well, don't let them give you any coat, it'll pass you out.
$1,500 silver dollars. Let's give these wonderful, courageous kids a great big hand, huh, folks? Bless us,
dearie. You want to sleep, son?
No, I'm too tired to sleep.
Sailor says you gotta go a long time. Maybe 500 hours before you can get so you can sleep while you're still moving. You look tired.
No kidding.
Why don't you try sleeping on my shoulder? I won't let you slip. You can trust me.
That's what the last guy said.
What?
Forget it. Gloria. She's there again. She must live here.
We really have to be nice to each other. Lola told me she's trying to get us a sponsor.
Nobody asked her to.
Look, it could be $4 a week, clean socks and new shoes. Come on.
I'm Mrs. Lady.
Yes, ma'am, we know. One of the four judges told us about how you're trying to get us a sponsor.
Well, that's because you're my favorite couple. You're wearing my number, 67. That's the year I was born.
Really? We're not supposed to stay in one spot for too long.
I understand. You go along, but don't give up. Because you're going to win. I know you are. But you think.
It's 2 hours. You told me to get you up in 2 hours, Rocky.
Shake me out of bed, Turkey. Listen to him. Those wonderful, wonderful people.
Bedelia. Shut the goddamn door. Wonderful. You gotta understand, I know. He thought it was him they believed in. But it was me. His fingers stretched over 13 notes.
What are you doing here? It's a rest period. You're supposed to be off your feet.
I was just looking at the sunset.
Go on, get off your feet.
Okay.
Sunset.
Matron. Somewhat. Medicine!
It's gone. It's gone.
What's gone?
My dress!
It's right in front of you.
No, no. My other one, my pink one. The chemicals for my hair. My rouge. And my lipstick. Everything is gone. Somebody's taken it out of my bag.
No, nobody's taken anything. It's probably just slipped under you.
No. They invented it. One of them stole my brain. Now, you stop. Stop it. You didn't
hear that. You heard it.
Hey, hey, hey,
hey, what the hell's going on here? Stop. Oh, I'm sorry. Come on. Hurry up and get out of there.
She's squealing.
Oh, I don't know. Please keep my milk satin.
Well, honey, you better shake it up. You only got a couple of seconds left.
But I only have two dresses.
Later. Just hustle the fanny out there. Come on.
Nobody wants your dress. Please wait.
I can't wear your other one.
Please wait.
Rather than despair, I'll die.
Why?
Nothing.
What are they doing it for?
It's not for fun. I'm Bella and Anna.
Christ. Here it comes.
I can't. Oh, Jimmy, I don't think I can.
Yeah, you can, honey. Just don't start thinking about it now. Son of a bitch.
The thing to remember, kids, is this is the kind of stunt that packs him in. Listen, we'll even get some of the Hollywood crowd out there tonight. Now get one of those uniforms you're passing out and make sure you tie your numbers on. Hey, number 63. Easy on the goods, huh? Listen, kids. These track outfits are being rented for one time and one time only, so any rips, tears, or malicious damage, you get charged, okay? Now, we don't have enough uniforms to go around, so the rest of you will have to wear sweatsuits, but they're very nice. We'll have the doctor and the nurses on the floor, so no one has to worry. Now, you kids who are pros already know how it works. I'm sure the rest of you all heard about it. And now you're going to see the Piazza of Derby! The supreme test of energy and endurance, 10 solid, wrenching minutes of wreck and ruin, the Derby! Good! Because you're in for an exciting extravaganza, Yowza, the Derby, and if I may be permitted to share a thought with you, there's a lesson for all of us in this, ladies and gents, contestants, if you hear me back there. You don't need to be number one as you amble down life's highway. But don't be last. Round and round and round they'll go for 10 little minutes. Who will set the pace? Who will win the race? Everybody excepting the last three couples. And now, here they are. Three couples are about to go bye-bye. Yes, indeed. Nurses and house physician, are you ready? Audience, are you ready?
you ready? All right, bring it in. Mr. Rhythm!
Out! The boy from 67 is down. He is definitely down.
What is it?
Have you heard anything
yet,
Mr. Graveler?
Don't worry about it, Alice. I've reported it to the authorities. We should hear something soon.
It can't just disappear. I mean, somebody must have taken it. It's not just my dress, it's my makeup and everything. I have nothing else.
The doctor's decision is... Lillian Kramer stays on in the marathon. The doctor assures me Lillian just has a slight sinus headache.
Headache. For all I quite know, she's got a brain tumor.
No, I don't think so. Only I'm not exactly sure. I think it's different from the brain tumor. Different symptoms.
Yeah, how do you know?
I saw it in a movie. With Anita Louise and Richard Cromwell. That's what she died of, Anita Louise. A brain tumor. But it was different. Everything just suddenly got dim for her one day. Until finally she couldn't see it all. She couldn't.
couldn't even see Richard Cromwell when she kissed him goodbye.
Yeah? What, she just died?
Kind of. She just drifted off listening to her favorite tune. And then she was dead.
No pain or anything?
They probably would have died. Hey, come on, kid. Come on, break shoulder. Come on. Tommy?
Hey, Frank, we got a dead one here.
I asked him, not you.
Kids have got to get off by themselves once in a while, but exhausted as they are, it's tougher to stay on their feet alone. So keep your eyes on them, because it may be all over soon for one of these brave, struggling kids. Tell him to turn up the controller. Listen to me.
They're crawling on me!
Where are they? Tell me. Tell me where they are. In your arm. Right here. In your shoulder. There. They're all gone.
I would have thought you'd put her on display. Charge a little extra.
No, it's too real. That little episode there didn't shake you up too much.
No.
Cigarette?
No.
And then the dance goes on and on. Remember, one admission entitles you to stay as long as you like. So while the kids are resting and being attended to by our medical staff, why don't you visit our beautiful palm garden where we serve refreshments of all types. Thank you, yowza.
It is. You can tell just looking at it.
Even if it is her dress, it's fooling now. There's nothing I can do about it.
But aren't you going to try to find out? I mean, somebody stole it and ripped it all up. Maybe you should call everyone together and try and find out who did it.
It wasn't one of the kids. For the good of the show. That's what we're all interested in, isn't it? The show.
No, it's a contest. Isn't that what it's supposed to be? Isn't that what you advertise? A contest.
Not for them. For you, maybe, but not for them. You think they're laying out two bits of gold just to watch you poke your head up into the sunlight, or Alice looks like she just stepped out of a beauty parlor? They don't give a damn whether you win, or James and Ruby, or Mario and Jackie, or the man on the moon, and little Miss Muffet. They just want to see a little misery out there, so they can feel a little better, maybe. They're entitled to that.
Look at us. We're all like this now. Dirty, swollen feet. No sleep? What do you want? Isn't that enough?
Sure. As long as they can believe in it. But how can they? With Alice looking like she's on her way to a ball at Buckingham Palace. She was breaking a spell. Now she looks like she's supposed to. So now they can believe in it. Simple enough. Why don't you go psych out while you got a little break time left?
Darling.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, our own Russ Colombo, Mr. Coley J.
Don't touch him. Don't! I have changed my mind. Your partner's waiting for you.
She was leaning against the railing. She was completely relaxed, completely comfortable. I didn't have a perfect view, but I could see enough of her face and lips to see that she was...
And to help us celebrate the occasion, Jeff Metzen and his music. Take it away, Jeff. Yowza! 1,000 hours of continuous dancing. 42 days of grueling, grinding, gravity-defying gyration. And here they still are. 21 courageous couples still dancing. And how before one of them, and just one, will survive to win the Monster Marathon?
Gloria?
Who's that?
No one.
1 o'clock.
No. I wish you'd get back to it.
Oh, you know what you think?
The tap.
You want to move on the other side?
No.
Sleep? No. The hell do you want? Anyone ever tell you?
Yeah, they told me.
Belongs to everyone.
of that night are all number 68. A lovely little lady with an arm full of charm, a room full of courage, and a house full of hope. And I know you all join me in wishing her and her bundle of joy a joyous ride through life.
Was worth it to you.
You need the money.
It's celebrity time again tonight, folks. A welcome for Miss Helen Twelvetrees and that rising young star, Mr. Russ Alexander. But every night is celebrity night at the Mammoth Marathon. Yowza, yowza, yowza!
Like my aunt. God, what a bitch.
Said he was gonna be here.
I mean, if that was a private mission, she'd have won.
Glasses of short, balding guy. Pits like from back.
Christ, you should have just whistled. You get that mangy mod out of here. You ain't bringing no animal into my boarding house.
Come on, a 10-day western of my room.
I wouldn't have brought him back down anyway.
Maybe something for me in it.
He just followed me, that's all.
Maybe.
And I wouldn't have kept him except she started screaming.
Hope he wasn't screaming.
I said I'd tell her husband she was screwing one of the boarders. Which she probably was. But he was sick inside or something. No, for Christ's sake, the dog. And it kept getting worse as he'd shake all the time and dirty himself all over. And whine and cry all night long. Stupid damn thing. He kept whimpering and hollering and wouldn't shut up. I mean, what the hell is God doing sitting around out there? What the hell good is he if he can't even make one lousy sick dog shut up and stop waking up from goddamn borders? You know what I did? See, after everybody called it night, I carried him down to the parlor. And she had this mohair sofa, it was her bedroom one. And I fixed him a place on it. What the hell, forget it.
Doctor can give you something to make you feel better.
God.
Some aspirin?
That's what I figured.
It's real sweet on your make this time around, just like that. And I'm the one that's got to tell Rod. Cheers.
You're getting into that song and dance crowd. What's going on?
Exactly what appears to be going on. I've shaved, I've changed, and I'm now back.
For what?
I have a job. So much of a job, it's a job. 10 days of a monogram western.
You bastard! You're not running out on me.
No. Just stand there and watch.
Will she make it? Will she make it? After over 1,100 hours of incredible endurance, there she is, alone, but still fighting, still hoping, still trusting, Gloria Beatty.
17 hours, that's all she has left. Will she find a new partner before those hours run out? Will fortune reward her pluck and spirit? Will she make it?
I ain't quitting. I'm not gonna give up.
What happens if I don't get a partner?
We've got 11, almost 12 hours.
I can count. What happens?
You know the rules.
You could change them.
Crowds got to have something they believe in. Once they quit believing, they quit coming. Anything else but not that.
kiss!
From our house physician. Nothing in the least serious, just a case of heat prostration. And I understand that Harry, plus the old salt that he is, wanted to stay out of the marathon, but the doc says no, and when it comes to something like this, the doctor's word is law.
It's gonna be all right.
So long, sailor. But we know you'll be back to see us. And to cheer the other kids on. You have 10 minutes to enjoy yourself in our beautiful Palm Bottom.
Oh, damn it.
Rachel. Does she want to come on now? Might catch cold in there. You don't want to do that to him. Please. Get out of here!
Is he dead?
Boy meets girl, boy loses girl, boy gets girl. That's the story of our sweetheart couple, Gloria Beattie and Robert Sarrazin. Now, I'm no Hollywood scenario writer, but I know what the end of this story should be. Right, Robert? Right, Gloria?
Wrong. Does the prisoner wish to make a statement to the court before sentence is passed?
Something that could help the show, something that could benefit all of us, and in particular could benefit the two of you, and at the same time give the folks out here something to get worked up about.
What are you going to do, put us in cages and let them throw peanuts at us?
No, all kidding aside.
Who's kidding?
The thing I want is I want you two kids to get married. Right here on the dance floor, a public wedding. I mean, you can divorce right after the show if you want. It's just for effect. What do you say to that, Robert?
I don't know.
He says no.
Does she do all the talking for you, Robert?
That's right.
Well, Robert. Maybe it'd be better to serve or discuss this. Okay?
Yeah, sure.
But the idea is okay with you. That's what you said, right?
No, sir. I didn't say that at all.
All I said was... Well, it's the same thing. It's the same thing. It's a spear knife. What's your problem? You afraid of getting married?
You're not happy until you've screwed everything up, are you? I'm not marrying anybody.
It's business. Strictly business, for God's sakes. Won't you come out with something? New clothes? Plenty of free gifts? Silverware? Waffle irons? Toasters? That kind of stuff?
What am I going to do with crap like that?
Sell it, Hawkett! Look, for God's sakes, I'm trying to help you a little. If you come out with $200 or $300, that's something. Unless you want to walk out of here with the pennies they're throwing at you.
Yeah? And what if just maybe we win?
Look, sweetheart. I've been in this business a long time. I may not know a winner when I see one. But I sure as hell can spot a loser.
You son of a bitch.
Maybe. You want to come out of this with a couple $100 or don't you?
The winners get $750 apiece.
Right. Less the bills.
What bills?
Look, this marathon don't run itself, you know. I got bills stacked up every day. I keep tabs. It just costs me money. Extra laundry, cleaning, phone calls, medical bills, you name it.
What is this?
It's the tabs in your Robert.
You're charging me this?
Only if you win. If you don't win, you don't pay. I'm not out to cheat anybody.
Oh, Jesus.
Gloria brings me back.
Well, don't just stand there. Why don't you help me?
What does it look like exactly?
Like this. What do you think it's going to look like? A necktie? I'll tell you one thing. I'm not leaving this goddamn stinkhole without it. That's the last pair I got. And I cut out streetcars for a month to get them.
Is this it?
No, for Christ's sake, it's silk.
Thank you.
fix it up or something, you know, and sort of sew it up.
Wait, let me see it. Maybe sew it up.
It's not the goddamn stocking anyway. Forget it.
What are you gonna do now? Try the movies again?
No. I'd never make it. And maybe it wouldn't make no difference even if I did. Maybe it's just the whole damn world is like central casting. They got it all rigged before you ever show up. I'm gonna get off this merry-go-round. I'm so sick of all this thinking thing.
What thing?
Life. And don't give me no sunshine pictures.
I wasn't going to.
Then what were you looking at me that way for?
Please.
I'm ready.
She asked me to. Obliging bastard. But the only reason you got kid.
They shoot horses, don't they?